Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this game one of FIBA Europe Cup, the two-legged first stage. And tonight we will be focusing on Borås basketball. And Ágyes Körmend from Hungary. With me tonight, my broadcasting assistant will be Per Lundström. Per, welcome here.
Thank you very much, James. How are you doing today?
I'm excited for basketball. I think this is going to be a great game.
Yeah,
we're gonna start off by talking a little bit about the clubs. First up, Ágyes Körmend. It's a historic Hungarian club. Three league titles and seven Hungarian cups, and the latest one coming in 2016. This is their sixth year playing in European competition in a row, and the last three has been the European Cup. And last year, they actually went to the round of 16. Per, you have some more information about it?
Yeah, we found out that Körmend have a long tradition in Hungarian basketball. It's only a small town of 12,000 people. But what we heard is they have a sellout every game of 2,000. So 20% of the town is on every game. So that's very impressive, and they seem to have a very dedicated fan base in the town. So 12,000, that's similar to Kina, where Borås basket came from originally. So that seems to be a club with a great tradition and a great dedicated fan base, what we found out. So.
Absolutely. And anything that you would like to add about some of the players that we'll be seeing tonight?
What we see here, they have four Americans straight out of college, actually. So four guys graduated last year, and it seems like almost like one of those mid-major conference all-star teams, because they're all from not the biggest colleges, but they are very successful in the mid-majors colleges. We have Marcus Wright here, 6'1", or 180, how long is he?
Around that.
Yeah, 183 centimeters from Siena College. And he actually played with Brett last year in college.
Yes.
Borås player, Brett
Bisping.
Yeah. So he was the leading scorer for that team, averaging 16 points in college at Siena. So that's pretty impressive stats there. Then we have Eric Fanning, also a guard, who's also 24 years, first year pro, coming from Boston University, not the bigger Boston College, but it's the Boston University in the little smaller Patriot League. Most famous team they have there in the Patriot League is Bucknell, who is usually the team going to the NCAA. But Boston University is like have been in the middle there, so not the biggest college there either, but a pretty good team. Yeah, so that's a little bit. We take that maybe the other ones when the game started.
Yeah, absolutely. We're going to see here. The starters from Borås are the Pearson brothers, number nine and number five. And also Giles Smith, Brett Besping, and Frederick Anderson will be starting for Borås Basket. On the other side, we have guard number one, Marquise Wright. See here, having a tough time making out their numbers, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sorry about that. Andre Hollins, number 15. Carvas Ferenc, the captain of the team. Also number 12, Milan Chervasi. And number 11, Eric Fanning will be starting.
Yeah.
We're ready for tip-off.
Andre Hollins is the American with little more experience, being third year here in Europe now, coming from Minnesota University. So he has some a little bigger school in America. So also some European experience. So we're all starting in a zone here.
Falling back into a man.
Yeah.
Here's Hollins for the pull-up three. Missed it. Besping with the rebound.
Good first possession for Borås, I think. Setting the tone with the defense.
Pearson up top. Passes Giles with the handoff. Coming back to his brother. Pick and roll up top. Pearson with the pull-up three. That's a miss. The offensive rebounds by Smith. Powers his way up. Oh, but he missed the layup. Rebound by Marcus Wright.
Good action there from Marcus with a good offensive board.
Miscommunication on defense, and Wright goes right to the basket. And that's the first lead of the game for Kerman. Now the other Pearson brother up top. Jonte passes Giles. Smith resets the screen on the other side. Cross court to Besping. Besping knocks down the triple right away.
Nice play.
I guess that's what they brought him in for, playing as a stretch four. Must be able to shoot the three-pointer, play tough defense and rebound.
Ooh, miscommunication there. Kind of got under right there, missed the three-pointer. But Hollins got the rebound.
A little bit too easy there.
Finds Chervasi inside for the easy layup. Now, Jonathan Pearson up top. Dribbling it out, looking for Anderson. Anderson gets the ball. Smith sets the screen. Anderson goes to work. Finds Smith. Swing on the ball. Besping attacks. I'm mixing Brett and Besping at the same time. Here's Venetia, the captain, for the three in the corner. And that is a 7-3 lead for Kerman.
Yeah.
Also a stretch four, it would
seem.
Pearson up top. Smith sets the screen. Pearson turns back. Reset. Besping up top, 3 seconds on the shot clock. Pearson has to get it off.
Yeah.
Defensive rebound by Eric Fanning as he pushes it up. Yeah. Anderson fouls.
I think the second offense in a row here, Borås' offense got kind of stale. Just a pick and roll, but nothing else happened there. So they all have to be more aggressive, I think. Towards the basket.
No doubt. Right up top, uses the pick and roll. They reset. Fanning on the wing, looking inside for Chervasi. Chervasi works the ball inside, works hard, gets stuffed by Smith. What a block.
Nice play. And that's what he brought him for, blocking shots. That's his.
And a quick attack by Pearson.
Aggressive.
Oh, and almost a steal by Brother Pearson, but they're coming back. Wright's pushing it up on the wing. Wright, pull up. Oh, knocked down. Great shot.
Looks very good.
You see right away that Kerman are trying to push the tempo here, and they really look great at this beginning of the game. Looking inside
for
Besping.
Actually, a little bit of a mismatch there.
Yes, yes.
Besping looks bigger than Ferenc. See if Borås can utilize that later on.
Yes, first baseline out of bounds play. Oop, Pearson gets tripped up. And Smith is the safety. Really working hard inside for Bisping. He's trying to get position. That's the second foul on the captain. We'll see if Coach Potocnik will make a change.
Yeah.
Once again, you find the safety Smith on the baseline out of bounds play. Pearson up top. Bisping looking for the ball. Gets tripped up again. Anderson has it there.
Yeah, have to be aggressive now. Yeah, that's the right one. Bro. Nice.
Anderson Frederick. Aggressive. Ooh, in that's and out nice. On that one.
That's good move.
Once again, Kermit on the run. Ooh, how did that not go in? Great offensive rebound right with the pull-up three. Misses, long rebound, reset, and there is a foul, and that's going to happen eventually when you let four offensive rebounds in a row come to the other team.
Borås player lost their positions. They were just scrambling around, and nobody had a man to guard, so easy offensive rebounds there for
first substitution of the game, out goes the captain, and in comes number eight, Sebastian Koch, and there's a change also in Borås. Out goes Frederik Andersen, and in comes Simon Gunnarsson.
Yeah.
Sees Kermend is more successful on their baseline play. Well, they find an open three for Fanning, and he knocks it down. Impressive start here by the Hungarian club.
Yeah.
And an aggressive Borås draws a foul down low. This time it's Andreas Persson. Per, what are your thoughts on the beginning here?
We
see a Borås team that's struggling a little bit. Yeah. What do they need to do to get back
I think they need to be a little bit more aggressive on offense here. I think Giles Smith is working hard. Setting screens, doing his thing, but the other players who are supposed to score have to step up a little bit more.
Oh, almost a great alley-oop, but he finds Gunnarsson on the cut. Easy two-pointer on the inside.
Nice pick and roll. Right, almost could have dunked that, but lost the balance. And nice assist to Simon Gunnarsson.
We've seen during the preseason, too, that Smith is a real unselfish player. He'd rather get his teammates involved than score.
I like what I see.
And you see that right there. Fanning with the attack, and he gets hit hard by Smith. Almost makes the and-one. Great attack once again from the Hungarians.
Yeah. Fanning showing here. He averaged 15 points and 6 rebounds as a senior here. So, and he finished his college career as the 14th all-time scorer, actually, with 1,200 points. So he knows how to score, and he's showing it so far here.
He really is. Right away, he's been aggressive. See here, the second substitution of the night. Wright goes out, and in comes Halatz.
Yeah. And Kermit actually have two Americans who haven't been on the court yet. So they looks like they have a deep team.
Absolutely. With the 6 Hungarians, 1 Austrian, and 5 Americans.
Yeah.
switching up on the outside. Yeah. Smith sets a screen again. Pull up from AP.
Very nice.
Missed there. Great rebound. And once again, we see Kermit. They're pushing the ball. Kovasi inside, working against Bisping. Smith helps out. Koch with the open three. Ooh, missed that one. And that's going to be a foul, and it looks like it's going to be against Borås.
I don't agree with that one. Bisping doing a good job on Milan there. And unfortunately, I think he slipped him. But he has Milan has a clear size advantage. So.
Up top, Harris. Smith checks at him, dribbles around, finds the open shooter once again. Good. Collins misses this one, but it is great offense. They are getting what they want at the moment.
Good rebound there. We Borås have to take the just allow one shot there to have a...
Oh, a look inside for Smith. Wasn't quite ready for it.
No.
Once again, we see Fanning pushing the ball. Yeah. Hollins, oh, hesitation. Ooh. Barely missed the layup. And Burroughs goes the other way. Oops. That's going to be an unsportsmanlike, ladies and gentlemen. And the referee feels that Halatz was not at all attempting to steal the ball, but just to stop the play.
Yeah. Good call.
Yeah, I personally agree with that call. I feel like he doesn't have position. No. He's just reaching to stop the play. A little bit lazy, could have had position there. I really feel like it's okay to take that foul, but you got to go for the ball. You got to be there with your body. And another substitution in Burroughs. Out goes Giles Smith, and in comes Marin Mornar. Real young, athletic, and hard worker on defense. This will be interesting to see if his energy can help Burroughs out and get them going a little more.
First game of the year also. I bet he's want to show what he can do today.
Absolutely. And Burroughs starts off with the T-game variation, comes up into the pick and roll. Mornar pops the three right away. Oh, that was short. Caught with the rebound, and the other way goes Fanning. Little slower this time for Kermend. They're looking for a special play. Here's Hollins coming across. Cuck has a ball up top. Great attack by the guard. Oop, that's probably going to be a kick ball there. Reset 14. Akos has come in and been really, really aggressive. Even though with one of the things being a foul, but he looks aggressive on offense too. Came in with a lot of energy.
Justin Totoya coming in now for what's the first year pro here from Chattanooga. Averaged 13 points in college, last a senior in college. Long athletic guy.
And apparently one heck of a shot blocker, if I remember correctly. He was seventh in the nation. So Burroughs.
He averaged 2.7 blocks per game his senior year, so
very, very impressive. Yeah. It'll be exciting to see if he gets some blocks tonight. And Fanning knocks down both the free throws. Looks like Jonathan Persson needs some help. Nope, he's got it. Akos once again with the aggressive defense. Andreas Persson looking for the pass,
nice,
finds the shot up and under. Nice move.
Very nice boom by Andreas, showing his quality.
Whoop! Oh, got a little high there. Once again, aggressive, finding the shooters. And here is a second or a third substitution for Burroughs. On the floor, Luda Johansson.
Yeah.
Young guard, just came out of high school.
Yeah. So he's first feel for the Heat.
Oh yeah. Being thrown in European play as a 8, or I think he's turned 19 now, but still young. Oh, sloppy turnover there by Mornar. Was looking for the pass to the young guard. Hard work inside. Here's Tuyu. Backing down. Tough shot. Missed it.
Yeah.
Got his own rebound. Put it in. Johansson brings it up to Gunnarsson. Persson on the wing. Here comes Johansson. Double screen. Swing pass to Bisping. Oh, I am doing that all night tonight, folks. Ooh, step back jumper. Tough one.
Yep.
Tuyu. Oh, stepped on the line. Unlucky.
A little bit lucky there. Burroughs.
Yes, Burroughs was very lucky to get that one back.
Burroughs doesn't get anything easy. They walk up the ball and long offices and not really any layups or anything like that. So they are playing very structured, but nice. That's a good
Bisping with a great pull up straight off the baseline play. That's the best one tonight. Oh, Persson almost with the steal. He gets it, goes straight to the bucket. 2 points there. And all of a sudden, it's a 4-point game here. The Hungarians have looked great all the first quarter, but here's that push up once again. They're
good
finding
defense.
Things
good
easy.
Defense.
Oh, what nice. A block by Mornar. My goodness, and Johansson, the young guard, not scared at all. Bisping gets the rebound. Missed it too. Johansson, is he going to get the foul? Hard work from the young guard. Unfortunately, that's going to be free throws for Corman.
I don't know. He went for the ball. I think he worked very hard there.
Yeah, he was working his butts off. It takes some guts to go in there with those big boys. I still can't get over that block here on the other side. It's too bad they didn't turn it into points. That was a great block. Yeah. And Fanning's at the line, and he is looking to get his eighth and ninth point. Yeah. He has definitely been impressive in this first quarter. Oh, jinxed him on that one. Sorry, folks. Rule broadcasting, don't ever talk about how many points somebody's doing when they're at the free throw line. There we go, unjinxed it. And there's also been a substitution in Corman. Tibor Ban is on the floor. And also Wright has come back into the game.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a slippery pass right there. Bisping got a hold of it, attacked the bucket. Oh, gets fouled. That'll be two shots.
Corman playing very aggressive defense far out in the on the court. If Borås is not aggressive, they're going to get stuck there. So the way to go is like Brett did there. Go to the basket.
Yeah.
Because there are openings then.
No doubt there. Bisping knocks down the first one, and we're at a four-point game once again. It looked grim for Borås there for a couple of minutes, but they've really found their footing a little better. They're pushing the ball up a little better, and the defense looks really good. Ooh, and he missed the second one. The classic, I don't want to sub out because I'm coming out, so I'll miss the second one.
Oh, you saw Mike coming.
Yeah, Mike's ready to check in. I'm guessing he's coming in for Mr. Bisping.
Nice hedge from
great aggressiveness. The clock's down. Oh, and that's what you get. You play some aggressive defense. Here comes the substitution, as we thought. Mike Palm is in on the floor, and Brett gets to rest some on the court. Mike Palm, really a Swedish legend. All kinds of records, and he's getting up there in age, but still fun to see him play.
Yep. I think he turned 38, actually.
He turned 38?
Yeah.
He can still stroke the three-pointer with the best of them, I guarantee you that. Uh-oh, Andreas is going to have to finish up. He's not going to get that one away. Oh, maybe? Nope. That's a shot clock violation. Too bad that went off his foot. It'll be Corman ball. I have to say I've been really impressed with the young Johansson. He doesn't look scared at all. And smart coaching too, keeping out of making too tough decisions, getting the ball out of his hand early. Koch with the great swing. Ban attack. Uh-oh. Uyo, what a dunk. Tuyo. Woo. Nobody was going to try to block that one.
No.
they're going to be on a poster. And it's a tough way for Borås really to end the first quarter, but a fun game so far. Speed going up and down, but we need a more aggressive Borås.
Yeah.
What are the coaches saying?
I think we can see now it's two teams have a lot of new players. Everybody's kind of a little bit nervous first game of the year. Borås have missed a lot of shots, but actually Corman have also missed a lot of quite easy shots. So maybe a little bit nervousness, maybe a little trying to learn to find each other. But so far pretty low scoring, but I think Borås got going there for a while.
Absolutely.
I think Borås have to stay aggressive, go to the basket, and seems like they picked up the defense also a little bit. So impressive so far, Andreas Persson. He's been the guy for Borås so far. 5 points. Yeah.
Absolutely. But you, like you said, Per, you look at the shooting percentages, it's not going to be very high scoring with 35% for Borås and 41% for Kermend. And it really, you can see this is the first game in Europe, and everybody's getting acclimated. But it's still been an exciting game. We've got some dunks, we've got some blocks. Yep. It's been a lot of fun to watch this first quarter. We look forward to much of the same in the next quarter.
Absolutely.
Let's see here. And for the first time on the floor tonight, we'll also see in Borås Emil Lundstedt, young shooter. And let's see if there are any changes in Kermend at this point. No, it does not look like it. Fanning has played the whole game, and I understand why. He has looked great out there.
Yeah, Emil comes in for Ludde. As you said, Ludde had a great 3 minutes, looking very confident out there for a 19-year-old. So I'm sure we're going to see him again this game.
Absolutely. Did a great job. And also, Jonte Persson subbed in for his brother Andreas. And right away, they're going to look for him inside. But Wright jumps the lane. He's going hard the other way. Look out. Ooh, probably should have thrown that one up. If he would have put that one up in the air, I'm pretty sure Tuju would have brought it down in the bucket. Gunnarsson up top. Yep. Attacks the center. Looks for Mornar. Mornar takes a contact. Nice. Easy lay-in.
Good play by Simon. Attacking, throwing defenders, and hitting Molnar in the stride there for a easy two.
Good. Tuju up top. Ban has the ball. Looks for Kopp. Fanning has the ball, end of the shot cut. Pull up three. Oh, knocks it down in the face of Gunnarsson. What a shot.
Looked good from the moment he left his hands.
Oh, yeah. He knew it was going in. He was running back. Lundstedt gets the ball up top, looking for Persson on the wing. Mornar sets the screen. Persson wants to attack the big. They look inside for Mornar. He
good
goes
play
to work on right. Kick out to Palm. He can shoot that. Ooh, off the ring. Fanning gets the rebound, and once again, Cormen is looking up with speed. Down low to Tuju. Ooh,
Mike
blocked
is big
from
there.
Behind.
Mike is big there. His size.
Oh, no. Ooh, that looked like a turned angle. He's all right. Yeah. Good, good, good.
Just slipped there.
Yep. All right, they're going to get a hand-checking foul there on right.
I think Mike have a good 10, 15 centimeter on Tuju, so
yep.
He can't really just turn around and try to and think he can just shoot it there. Mike is too big for him.
Agreed.
So if they keep going to him, I think we're in good shape. Borås is in good shape. Nice drive.
Persson attacks, switches to the right hand, puts it in.
That's nice.
Looking more composed here from Borås. It's a 3-point game, but Kermed still has the advantage. It's a 5-point game. Apologies.
Yeah.
Shot. And they're going to call that foul, and they do that often. Yeah. Little guy trying to get in front of a big guy.
Emil switched on the Tuju there and tried to hold him from posting up, but did it illegally, I would say.
And Tuju up top. Wright trying to get the ball. Oh, deflection by Persson. Shot clock's down to 7. Wright looking for the push-up. Attacks left side, right-handed finish. Ooh, lovely touch.
I actually like Borås' defense here. Like, lost a couple of possessions there, but the skill of Wright was too much there. Just
good offense almost always beats good defense. Anderson with the 3. Off the iron. Oh, little Lundstedt inside gets the offensive rebound. Persson resets. Horns variation. Mornar goes. Hand off to Anderson. Back to Persson. Persson goes at the basket. Finds Anderson in the corner. 1 second left. Needs to finish. And that's a shot clock violation. Tough to go up against those two shot blockers. Probably should have shot it in the corner.
He missed the first one, so I guess You really should have shot that one also.
Yep, got a pretty good look there. Yeah, you got to be confident. Let's see, we got some substitutions. Hollins comes in, and also for the first time in the game, number 20, Nemeth. And also, Brett Bisping is back in the game, and Mike Palm gets a rest after a good first look here. Too bad he didn't make his three. He is almost always automatic from there, but see him. Pearson picks up Hollins.
Playing really good defense.
Real aggressive. Mornar hedges out. Rotation.
Jonathan.
Pull up there from Ban. Ooh, off the ring, and Bisping takes care of the rebound and the other way.
I think Boros take that shot every day in the week.
Yeah, I totally not agree
really
with you. A long, Kermit. Contested pull-up, that's always great. And that's going to be a foul on Tuyu. Yeah. And Mornar is doing a really good job opening things up by rolling to the basket.
Yeah, that's the play Boros is going for almost every offense there. The big guy rolling down the middle. And see if they start to get some result from it.
Oh, short on that first one. Knocks down the second one. And that's a 6-point game. 6 minutes and 40 seconds left in the first half. Hollins up top.
Good defense by Jonathan Pearson there.
The brothers, both the Pearson brothers, known for their ability to play aggressive man-man defense. Tuyu up top. Ooh, looks for the fake handoff, gets stopped by Anderson. Up top is Nemeth. Takak. Ooh, knocks down the triple, no hesitation there. That was a deep one.
Yeah, that was kind of a offense gone bad there also, but he got a shot.
Got bailed out by a great shot there. Anderson attacks the basket. Lundstedt doesn't hesitate from the corner. Ooh, ring out. Hollins gets the ball and pushes it right down. Nemeth on the wing. Rejects the screen first, then brings it back. Hakota. Ooh, Hollins shakes. Gets stopped. 10 seconds left on the 24. Kot gets caught in the air.
Yeah. Good defense.
And that is a deflection, and that's Burroughs' ball. They are playing good, aggressive defense, and here comes Giles Smith.
He's been on the bench for a long while here now.
Yep. And I know, speaking to the coach, this will be one of the tough things because he likes both Mornar and Smith. Yeah. They bring different things to the game.
Yeah, okay.
But good to see Giles will be back with some aggressive physical defense. Yeah. Lundstedt attacks, looks for Pearson. Pearson turns the corner, back to the shooter. Emil still doesn't hesitate. This time he knocks it down.
He also looks confident. And he had played in big games before in European Cup. So
absolutely. Seen so much happen for that young man. Yeah. I've coached him since he was 17 years old. And just last year getting to play a lot in the Swedish league just built his confidence, and he comes in off the bench and he is not hesitating when he gets that open shot. And Kermed wisely takes a timeout, but I really feel that they still have a decent control of the game, but it is very smart of the coach to slow things down and reset here and just see what's going on. Borås might be close to making a run, but right now they're still in control of the game.
Yeah, I think Borås picked up their defense now in the second quarter and actually had some great stops, but Kermand made some tough shots now in this quarter, so I think that's why they're still ahead.
And we can also see here, look at the overall shot percentage has gone up some. Borås is now at 37%, and Kurmend is at 43%.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see if there are any changes in the teams. Yes, it looks like the captain is back on the court, yeah. Number 15, Ferenc. And also number 12, Milan Sorvasi.
Yeah.
To all our Hungarian fans who are watching at home, I am sorry if I am butchering these names, but I am doing my best.
Nice aggressive move again from Jonathan.
Yep. That one might have been close. Oh boy. That's going to be on the floor. Let's see if they're going to get it on the sideline. Yes, they are. Smith once again to safety. Hand off to Person. Person swings it to Anderson, who attacks the bucket. Gets fouled on the shot. Might have got lucked out there. I would have liked to see a dump to Smith there. Yeah. That would have been wonderful to watch.
But Frederick was aggressive there, going to the basket and throwing a foul. So that's a key move anyway. So
we see it, and I understand that the captain's upset because he just got his third foul. I believe, yes, he did after just about a minute on the floor. So, but once again, like you said, any time that Burroughs is aggressive, good things happen.
Yeah.
And we've seen that for Kremen when they've been controlling the tempo and being aggressive, Burroughs has had a tough time stopping them. So it's all about the controlling the tempo. And a full court press, zone press, see if they fall back to a 3-2. Nope, they switch back to a man.
Yeah.
Tuyo with the screen. Hollins looking to attack.
Good job by Emma Lundstedt on defense now.
Nemeth attacks the basket. Ooh, ring out. Milan under almost gets it back, but Person scratches it to him.
Very
crossover. Here's the lob. Oh. Ah, Smith just barely missed it. Great rebound by Kravasi. And Nemeth starts the offense. Hollins wants to attack. Tough to get in the paint. Tuyo stretches it from the corner. Triple knockdown by the big man. And we also saw that looking at his scouting report from college. He's good with his back to the basket, but he can shoot that three if you give him a chance to. Anderson with the pull-up. Miss. Kravasi with another rebound.
Good, Frederick. Keep shooting that. Got it. Come around the corner, aggressive there.
Hollins up top. Gets the screen from his big man. Attacks Smith. Uses his body great. Gets the contact, and it's tough for Smith to do anything there, really. You can almost say that Hollins is creating the contact, but it's really, really tough to do anything other than blow a foul down.
I guess you're right there, but I don't. It's not much contact by the body, and
you don't like that call. You're a player from the 90s. That wouldn't have gone home in the 90s. You could have thrown him down. Could have thrown him down on the floor, and it would have been a no call, right?
Yeah.
I'm with you. Once again, though, aggression pays off, and that has definitely been the definition of this first half.
Hollins with his first point there, but he'll miss it.
Yeah, he rimmed it out there. Okay. So let's see if he knocks down this second one. Yes, he did. So he's on the board. Timeout for Burroughs Basket. And I really have to say that I'm impressed with Burroughs keep jabbing because Kremen is really close to running away right now, and they just keep hitting back. Great timeout here by Svensson to see if they can make a run these last 3.5 minutes and make it close by the half.
Yeah, I agree here. It feels like the game is on the edge for somebody, tipping over to somebody. But I think the teams are pretty even. I think the more aggressive team who can make a run will win it. But
surprising, though, that Eric, let's see here. Yes, Eric Fanning has played the first 12 minutes and 50 seconds, and he hasn't seen the floor since. And he has really been one of the better players, probably the best player on the floor so far.
Yeah.
Let's see if if there's going to be made a change. But yeah. right now, Cormier has looked stable. So
yeah, I guess they do that when they have like a deep team, because it was the same with Tuohy, who didn't play the first quarter almost. So yeah. I think he came in the end of the first, and he's been great so far, I must say.
And we still haven't seen
7 points, four boards, and yeah.
And we still haven't seen Stephen Smith either, and I'm not sure if he's hurt or. But they are definitely a deep team. Yeah. There is no doubt about that. Pearson starts off the offense. Bisping with the screen. Goes around looking for the outlet. Hollins picks it off. Being aggressive, going to the basket, lays it in for his third point of the game.
Nice move, controlled, calm.
And was able to finish with his left hand going on the left side.
I don't think Burrell's play was the play coach wrote up there.
No, I agree with you there. I don't think they wanted Bisping to play the Tony Parker role under the basket with dribbling around down there. Oh, great cut. Good look. Didn't get it. He's going to catch him out. Nope. Great. Whew. That could have been a nice dunk, but mistimed the pass just a little bit. Yeah. Nemit with a good look shot, but didn't quite go in. Pick and roll up top. Aggressive defense once again. Bisping wanted to take the shot. Hesitated. Pearson with the attack and the look at the floater. Ooh. Got knocked out there. Andreas Pearson up top. He wants a screen. Bisping sets one.
Short shot clock now.
Yep.
Have to shoot it.
Got to put it up. Smith with a tough finish. Off the rim, gets his own rebound, and gets fouled. Ooh, they got lucked out on that one.
I think so too, actually.
That was that wasn't great offense. It looks a little stagnant right
now. Yeah, it does. Everybody's looking at each other and who's going to do who, who's going to do what. So somebody got to take initiative and do something here in Borås.
And here are some substitutions. Eric Fanning comes back in the game, and so does Wright. And Marin Mornar is on his way as well. But it's clear also, and you look at different ways of playing offense, and Borås has an offense that's relying a lot on pick and rolls and movement, but right now the ball is getting stuck, so there's not really any defensive movement, and then it's tough to break down the defense. When you look at Cormand, how they're playing offense, the ball is moving from side to side. They're attacking, forcing the defense to collapse, and Burroughs is working really hard. Yeah. But
for every point.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
We'll see if it started fall sooner or later.
Here we go. They're looking for Fanning right away and comes back into the game. Pick and roll with Tuohy. Right. Korvasi goes aggressive to the basket. Yeah. That's tough for him to stop. Yeah. There's and Coach Svensson takes another timeout, but that's really tough for Marin, because
that's a mismatch.
There's
it's a
too
guy.
Many pounds there.
Yeah.
Can't stop it.
Nice offense from Kermit. They knew what they wanted and got him the ball, and he delivered. So nice play.
No doubt. It's going to be interesting to see what Henrik Svensson, the coach for Borås, does coming out of this timeout. Usually a coach who likes to throw a lot of different things at teams, different types of zones, different kinds of presses. I wouldn't be surprised that after this this offensive possession for Borås, that they come back in some kind of zone or traps or something like that. They need to do something here coming right out of this timeout, that's for sure.
Yeah, it would be nice to get like 1:29 left of the quarter, if they could get it down to maybe score two offenses in a row and get it down to 5 or 7 points. It's a lot easier starting the third quarter with that than 10 or 12 points down. So we'll see what they do here, what the plan is.
Most definitely. Gunnarsson on the wing. Dribbles over Andreas Persson. Hand off to his brother Jonte. Here's that pick and roll. Gunnarsson attacks. Ooh, he slipped. Unlucky there. We finally got some movement offensively. The ball was going from side to side. Good attack there. Unfortunately, Gunnarsson slipped, and that's a turnover. Cormann the ball.
Oh, yeah. I don't really know what they were looking for there. It was three handoffs, 2 meters outside the three-point line, and the pick and roll there was...
Well, let's see if they can have a good defensive possession here. T game for Cormann.
They go to the
easy
big guy
layup for the big guy.
Nice move. He's got some skills.
No doubt about that. No doubt about that. A fun fact for those back home is the big man who just Milan Corvasi. Yeah. Made the layup there is an old college teammate of last year's captain Jakob Iceman Sigurdsson, who's on the bench now right now with a
oh, really?
Foot injury. Yes, they played together in college.
Okay.
Also a mid-major. Ice is getting closer in his rehab. They could have needed his shooting tonight. Yeah. There's no doubt about that.
36 seconds left of the quarter. Kermed with the ball. They can go up 14 or 15 points here. So important possession for Borås. We'll see if they go to Milan again there.
Yeah, he has been really hot. He has been working inside. I would love to see Ace. Oh, right to the hole. That is not good enough. There is no help side there. Brett has to take a step in and help out there. Got to help each other out on that one. There's no doubt that the Ooh, what a dunk by Tuyu, and this is really a nightmare of a finish to the first half for Borås, and great play for Kerman.
Look at the basket.
Uh-oh, that's gonna be two free throws. I understand Nemeth's frustration, but...
What happened?
He got called for the defensive foul in the position game against Mornar. And coach is going to take a timeout here and see if they can figure something. A last second play with 2.5 seconds left after the free throws. Always fun to see if there is going to be a full court pass or some other variation to see if they're going to get away a shot.
Yeah.
But first of all, Marin needs to shoot his free throws.
Yeah. Borås really need those two now, so hopefully he can.
No doubt about it.
Put it in.
There is psychologically a huge difference between 16 and 14 points.
Yeah. Huge.
And I think it's as simple as when it's 14, you feel like you're pretty close to 10. When it's 16, you feel like it's getting close to 20. And so let's hope for the game's sake that Marin knocks down his free throws and see what Coach Potocnik has after the free throws. Makes the first one. misses the second one. Full quarter almost. And that one's off. Watch out in the first row. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is the first half of our game. And we will be back in about 10 minutes with some of our analysis of the first half to get you ready for the second half. We'll see you guys in about 10 minutes.
Passar så på att köpa matchprogram till bra vinnarna i den första timeouten i tredje kvarten. Och ni kan vinna presentkort från Ica Byntorp, bilträffar ifrån Green, brunch på en lördag, presentkort på Kinala Land och en lampa ifrån TRH. Kvällens matcher, alltså Swedbank Sjuhäradet, tillika huvudsponsor.
prata lite då.
Okay. Okay, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to start with some of our thoughts and summations from the first half. I'm going to hand it off to you, Per. Some of your thoughts about this first half?
I think Borås offense is not getting... They can't get going here. We see that their stats here. They're shooting 7 for 20 on two-pointers and 2 for 10 on three-pointers. And I think they are a little bit unsure what they should do and who should take the shots, and a little bit hesitant to play, actually. So I think hopefully they can get going here in the second half and start with a good defense and maybe can get the offense going.
We talked some too about the fact that the team that has controlled the tempo has controlled the game, really. And it's been clear that Kerman are just absolutely controlling the tempo.
Yeah.
And one of our thoughts was as well that Borås coach is thinking that if both teams are going to run, that might be a problem for Borås. At the same time, the offense is just really stagnant right now.
Yeah.
We'll look at the other side of the ball, Kerman. They just stable play, 46% from two, 45% for three.
Yeah.
Now that might change, that is a high percentage.
Yeah.
But nevertheless, their offense looks really stable.
Yeah, they have some two really good guards and very good big guys. So they have a nice offense from outside and inside. So and they have shown both this first half here. So pretty impressive team, I would say.
And they have shown their depth.
Yeah.
There is no doubt about that.
Yeah.
Like we said, there are some players that we still haven't seen, but everybody who's been on the floor has been impressive. All the Hungarian players and all the imports that we've seen on the floor have been impressive. I have been really impressed with Eric Fanning's play this first half.
Yeah.
11 points, but that doesn't do him all the justice with 11 because he sat out quite a while there. But high percentage and really impressive.
Yeah, really impressive. Shooting good, high percentage. Five rebounds also. He's an athletic shooting guard, small forward. So, yeah, he's been really good.
And also the big man inside, Milan Trevasi, has just... He ate up the defense at the end of that first half.
Yeah, he came on strong on the end there, and he was the one who started for them to pull away a little bit. So I think he was, he's good.
No doubt, he was the architect of that late run by Kermed.
Yeah.
Looking forward to the second half, hoping for a little tempo coming right out of the gate from Borås here. Try to tighten this one up so we get an exciting game going down to the line.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll see the Borås tactics here if they go for how they play in the beginning here.
This is going to tell a lot about dictating, and they have to come out and really dictate the tempo in this second half, and we'll see. We'll see
what they do. We have a problem here. Everybody's ready to play except the referees are not here yet.
Oh, that's right.
Here
they come.
Here they come. Oh, already.
They're warm.
Yeah.
They're ready to go. They had a coffee, and
they're
good to go for the second half.
They have really nice fika in Borås.
Yes, they have great fika here in Borås.
Yeah.
For those of you who aren't Swedes, fika is just the best.
Yeah. Yeah, but now
coffee and cakes, ladies and gentlemen. But the refs look ready, the players look ready. I don't know if we look ready, but we are ready, aren't we?
Yep, we are ready.
All right.
Two getting the start in the second half, instead of Nemeth, I would say.
No, Fernes,
who has
been in foul trouble.
Yeah.
But
he has three fouls,
It's a good substitution. Tuyu had a very good, productive first half.
Yeah.
T-game off the start here. They're going to... Holland's up top, looking for the big man.
Yeah,
here comes a double right away.
Yeah.
Smart play. Wright has it up top. This is actually, I think this is a 3-2 zone. I apologize for the late call, but I believe that Borås was in a 3-2 switch
actually
zone.
Actually good defense. Oh, go
for it. Go for it, Freddie. Goes up hard. Yeah. And oh, and one. Borås needed that one.
Yeah, good defensive possession. Getting on, getting out and pushing tempo and actually have an outlet there for an easy 2 points plus one. So
he really looked hesitant at first, and then he just went for
Should
it.
I go for it?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Just go get him. And right away, push the tempo. Like we talked about in the first half, Coach Svensson is not afraid to try different things. Let's see here. Okay, they're back in a man-man. See if there are any switches. Holland's trying to get the ball up top. They're going back inside to Milan. There's got to be a rotation down to that shooter. Fanning going to the rack, finishing with the left hand. Great finish. Just looks so easy getting to the
there,
basket.
Nothing. Taking it easy.
Smith up top, looks for Anderson. Anderson attacks, kind of gets stuck up top for Jonte Persson. Pull up off the short rim. Hollins gets the ball. Ooh, gets fouled by Frederik Andersen. Yeah. He didn't agree with the call. I think it was a bit of a 50-50, but foul nonetheless, and it will be Kerman ball.
Frederik's third.
And right away, the substitution for Simon Gunnarsson. Also, at that point, you know, you got two fouls.
Yeah.
Don't need to go for that one, you know.
Reach there.
Just back it up home, play some defense there. Hollins just get it going, puts it up high for Wright, and Wright's going to initiate the offense.
Yeah, and picking up full court there. So,
almost looked like it went off of Wright's foot, but like we talked about in the first half, Pearson brothers, great one-on-one defenders, and they are picking up full court here. Hollins runs for it, Wright ends up with the big man, Milan Korvasi. And now Wright is going to initiate. This is a short call, looks like, from Wright. Korvasi comes up. Aggressive switch out. Ooh, this might be trouble. Hold him for the 3 second. Ooh, he got out. Gunnarsson on the help. Tough shot there by Hollins. And now, yes, Borås is pushing the ball. This is what we've been looking for. And once again, they get something good going. Yeah. I was scared when...
Good defense leading to good offense. Two times here, beginning of the third quarter, actually. So
but when we saw Milan back down to Andreas, that scared me a little bit. If they would have given him the ball there, that would have been two automatic points. But once again, good defense from Borås and good speed going the other way. Let's see if he can finish this off with 2 points from the line. Ah, he did it again.
Yeah. Borås is...
What's the free throw?
9 for 13, 69%.
Yeah, that's not quite good enough here. Knocks down the second one. All right. Here we go. But a good start from Borås.
Yep.
13 points now. It feels like it should be less, but Kerman are just really controlling. And Fanning has been awesome. Good pass there to Milan. Wright tries to turn the corner. Ooh, that was close to a foul. Bespink jumps it. Oh, another unsportsmanlike. Yeah. And I understand Tuyu doesn't understand it, but what happens there, he doesn't have a chance to get the ball, just reaches up to stop Bespink, and that is an unsportsmanlike every day of the week, guys.
We're all coming out the right way here in the third quarter with aggressive defense.
And aggressive offense. Bespink knocks down the first one. And the second one, that's an 11-point game, ladies and gentlemen. And Borås ball up top here.
Brett actually leading scorer for Borås with 8 points so far.
Yeah, they need him to score, too. There you go, Brett. European rules, a little bit different than American rules. So you got to have one foot on each side of the line to pass back and forth.
Yeah, I guess Brett is straight out of college also.
Oh, pull up three right away. Ooh, off the front iron. Yeah. Rebound by Milan Korvasi. Wright pushing up the ball again.
Nice hedge.
Yep. Like the look of that. Fanning goes to attack. What a spin move. Oh, that's an unsportsmanlike. Yep. Same thing for Smith there. Doesn't have a play on the ball and kind of reaches to stop him from behind. There, no discussion there, unfortunately. That is an unsportsmanlike. Two shots for Erik Fanning, and Kerman will have the ball. Looks like we're going to have a substitution. with Giles Smith picking up his third foul, Marin Mornar is back in the game. And he came out with some aggressive...
Really nice work from him, hedging the pick and roll and actually being a very good defender. So we kind of need him.
They really do. Mornar had a very good first half, but he got hurt inside against the big man, Milan Kovacic. Fanning knocks down the first one. And the second one, and we're back to 13 here in Boråshallen. Corman ball.
So, and two intentional fouls really early there.
But I mean, reading the new FIBA rules, they are tighter on that, even tighter than they have been this year. Yeah. And here's another good hedge. Good pass out to Tuyo for the triple. He hits another corner three. And that is tough. Don't know where the help's supposed to come from. That is just a straight line attack. They really can't let him go that hard to the basket. But that's good offense once again. Let's see if Mornar can answer with the three. Oh, that one was short. Gunnarsson with the offensive rebound.
Yeah, keep being active there, Simon.
Ooh, Pearson shakes off right. Ooh, they both lost the ball, and that's a 24-second violation. A little sloppy there. Both were aggressive, but just too sloppy. And good defense from Corman. The call is yellow. Let's see what we get here. High pick and roll.
And they switch.
And a switch there. Back. Hollins, another switch. I do not. There we go. But that's a problem too. Fanning probably. He shouldn't have done anything other than what he did. What a dunk! Nice I thought play. He should have fed the big man, but why not just go in and dunk it?
Yeah.
I like that play.
Very nice play. Just kind of got open on the baseline and showed off. He can jump.
I've really been, you know, he just looks so calm.
Yeah.
In everything he does, he
very
really
controlled.
Very controlled. And you're kind of like, wonder what he's going to do. And then just smashed it there.
Got 17 points now. Shooting a very high percentage.
He's been impressive. Yeah. He's really been impressive. The five on the floor right now has been really dominant. Yeah. You look at the plus-minus numbers here. Wright plus 18, Tuyo plus 12, Hollins plus 10. And Fanning and Trevasi both at plus 15. Yeah. It's been a dominant five. Really impressive here. A must timeout for Henrik Svensson. And as he tries to get the troops.
Can't let it slip away too far here now.
Nope. No doubt about that. Tough situation too for those of you who don't know. Jonte Persson, number 9 on the floor right now, came in about a week ago to replace injured guard Nimrod Hillard IV, and has really fit into the team real quickly. But it is tough to be here for a week and then play in Europe. But he's been pretty impressive here, impressive so far. And as we mentioned, Jakob Iceman Sigurdsson is also injured, and that is a great outside presence and scorer. And Cormen comes out in a 2-3 zone.
Yeah.
Interesting. Let's see what Borås does with that. Attack from Persson, just mentioned, he came in a week ago, but that was a tough shot.
Yeah, not really good offense there from Borås.
Real smart move. Always love to do that when you're coaching. When the other coach calls a timeout to make an adjustment, you make a change.
Yeah.
And a great change made there by the Slovenian coach, Potocnik, to go right to a zone. But it looks like they might go back to a man-man right away. Just one time zone, mess up the offense. Yeah. So
that's a classic.
Great coach in there.
Yeah.
Gunnarsson still looking to pass the ball, like you said in the first half. We would like him to be more aggressive. Andreas Persson, that's going to be an offensive foul. Hip comes out there a little bit. It's a 50-50 call. Ref thought it was moving. Not much to discuss there. Corman ball and Borås.
After a good start here in the third quarter, they can't get anything going. Lost a couple of possessions here. So
We'll see.
Right up top. Kravasi with the ghost screen. Holland's on the wing. Kravasi's going to go to work like he did in the... Oh, what a move. They're going to call traveling on him there. That was a close one.
Pretty nice move there.
But we like those inside moves. Let's see if they can get something going here again. But once again, I really feel like the tempo is too low.
Yeah.
Even though it's set. Oh, great cut. They missed him. Bisping for the three. And Wright gets
Bisping
the rebound.
Bisping coming out aggressive here. Second try for a three-point try.
Wright's aggressive. Gets fouled. Let's see what the Danish referee says. Two shots there. Didn't see who was on. It was on Andreas. Okay. Hard to see from up here. Not shocked by the call. Here's another substitution. Big Mike. Mike Palm is back in the game. Let's see if he can get the offense going. Great offensive player. See if he can knock down some threes. Yeah. They surely need it right now.
Yeah.
Wright knocks down the first one. Off the front iron and in, knocks down the second one. And here comes Halac.
You got a 21-point lead now, so.
Yep, and Koch is back on the floor.
Slipping away.
Yeah, they really need to do something here. And this is a two-legged game too, or two-legged series. So coming back from, even though if you're gonna lose this game, if you're going to lose this game, you got to make it closer than this to have any kind of a shot for the return down in Kremen, and especially if they're going to have 2,000 screaming fans in that arena, they definitely need to close this in.
Yeah.
Ooh, look at Mike. Oh, sorry. There it is.
Yeah, nice.
Good play. About a half a second from a five-second call, but didn't matter. They got the layup.
Nice defense.
Ooh, they're going to call on that one.
Andreas playing very good defense. Almost got the steal, and the referee found a foul there.
Yeah.
And a team foul for Borås already. Oh, both teams, actually.
Both teams and the team foul. Well, it has been an aggressive quarter. Like we said, there was two unsportsmanlike the first minute and a half, so... there's been a lot of aggression. Nothing ugly, just aggressive, good play.
102 for Alas.
Yep. It's those last names. Gunnarsson up top. Let's see if he can be aggressive. Hollins with the defense. Bisping with a handoff to Pearson. That's the one we've been talking about. Needs to put the ball down in the corner.
There we go.
Oh, good aggressiveness. I wish we could get a replay on that, but once the swing goes over here, Andreas Pearson, who is a great three-point shooter, is open down in the corner. And we talked about this actually during the half, that a lot of Borås plays has a movement that lets the corner shooter get open. Unfortunately, they have not been finding the corner shooter real well. And that cuts it to 20. Yep. We need to cut it closer for Borås' sake.
Ooh.
That was a close one. Bisping gets up to double
Bisping
digits.
Bisping showed good intention, I think.
Hollins with a pull-up three. Oh, man, that is a dagger. What a shot. Comes straight up and knocks that one down. Ooh, that's tough. 22 points once again. Stagnant offense. Here comes the pick. Mike pops. See, and this is what we're talking about. Andre or Jonte's been here for a week, and if he had been here for the whole preseason, he would have found Mike for the open three. Too bad. Brett makes an aggressive move on the baseline. Unfortunately, steps on the baseline as well. That's Kremen ball. Hollins initiates the offense. Tuiu, he can shoot that.
Got Mike on him, but Mike's doing a good job there.
Yeah, closed out real well. Real well, 38 years young. And the defensive rebound. He's all over the place right now. Here we go, a little speed. The Pearson brothers like that. Fanning up. Ooh, that's a tough finish. That could have been a call, but Kerman comes the other way. Pearson is right up again, and he's back playing defense. Halat uses Tuyo's screen. Uh-oh. Ooh, no, no! Wow, that was a trap. I'm sorry. That was a great attack by Tuyo, but that was a block and a travel if I've ever seen one. Oh, man, they got lucked out on that.
He had a ball.
Yep. But in true Mike fashion, he doesn't discuss the call, never does. But, trying to be neutral here, but that one was... That was a block, but great intention by two. I'm impressed that Mike went for it. I thought he was going to get dunked on.
No.
Knocks down the first one to you, as we spoke of in the first half when he came into the game. Great athlete, great shot blocker, just a jumper. So looks like
2 for 2.
Looks like a substitution for the first time into the game is number 6. Balin Torti.
Yeah, two got 14 points, 6 rebounds in 20 minutes of playing time.
Just impressive.
So, yeah.
And Johansson, once again, absolutely fearless, gets fouled here. I've been impressed by this young man.
Yeah.
I got to say, I have been watching them in the preseason, and he hadn't shown me much in the preseason, but this game has been impressive from the young man. He looks more aggressive than a lot of the veterans.
Yeah. Got two shots here now also. And they tried to double team him, so.
He just went.
The rest of the team need to communicate with him.
Get in there. All right, Luda is officially on the scoring board.
Yep.
One shot coming up here. Still a 23-point game. Make that 22, both of them.
Nice.
Shooter's touch on both of them. Here we go. Hollins is gonna bring the ball up.
Good defense again.
Yeah, that one-on-one defense is...
Good defense by Ludo also.
It's intensive.
That's okay.
Ooh, Mike rotate a little late. Fanning, oh, great pass to Koch. Ooh, that's got to be something somewhere. There we go. All right.
Mike is the big guy there.
We can almost count these two.
Yeah.
Career 92% free throw shooter, Mike Palm is. So... That's a good thing for Barros. They really need to get something going here. 22 points.
Get it down to 20 here now.
Horty comes in right away. Aggressive going for that that offensive rebound, which is great. Coming in with energy. Unfortunately, got caught with the foul there and the rebound.
No jinx there.
No. I was going to say that. I was going to wait till he made the second one. I've done it twice already tonight. Oh, boy. Thank you, Mike. All right, no jinx there. He couldn't hear me. All right. Here we go.
Mike with his two first points here.
Full court zone press.
Yeah.
The 2-2-1.
There you go.
And a little bit of a trap. Let's see if they go down to a 2-3 or if they're going to match up. They have matched up. All right.
Number 6. Horty is on the court for the first time here.
Exactly. Rolls hard to the basket, misses a little hard, and Bisping. I really like this. Oh, pop that! There you go. Oh, they needed that one.
Yeah.
And Cormann.
He didn't hesitate and he shot it. I think I like that.
Uh oh. Kick. Yeah, exactly. You see Fanning. Trying to show that he wanted the ball from the wing, and it would have been points. I can almost guarantee it. And a timeout here. It's a 20-point game, but Kerman just looks real good, controlled,
solid team,
real solid.
Yeah.
It's going to be tough to make a run on that team because they are not in a hurry to do anything.
No.
Even when they're pushing the ball, they're under control.
Yeah.
I've been real impressed so far. And once again, they show their depth. They've got their 11th player in the game, yeah. So 11 players have played.
Yeah.
And
balanced team.
Yes, and Horti comes in, does some good things, yeah. Aggressive on the offensive yeah. rebound, rolls well to the basket, yeah. Missed the layup, but just
not
comes in right away.
Yeah,
yeah, it's really, really impressive. And
yeah, we'll see what Borås can do here. Last 2 minutes of the third quarter. Looking quite aggressive here with when Ludde comes in.
I agree.
He brings the other players with him, and
really enjoying that. It's been really impressive. Coming in aggressive. Kids 19 and just no mercy. Maybe it's that fact 19 doesn't know any better. But we love it nonetheless. Oh, I thought Hollins was gonna he's gonna shoot that second one. That's gonna be a dagger. Yeah. Wow, you just cannot give him that space. He is too good of a shooter from the outside. And that's the second one. Look at this kid. Way to be aggressive, young man. Mike on the wing, Luda gets the ball back. You want some looks inside for Bespin. This is going to be a turnaround.
Yeah.
Oh, no, he
nice.
Takes it to the rim. I like that.
Nice.
And Brett really looks aggressive here.
He settled down a bit and started to play basketball, and I think it should go to him more. He doesn't hesitate to shoot the threes, and
Agreed.
Need someone to score here.
Uh-oh, that's a knockdown. Oh,
go.
He's really showing that he's a great shooter, Sebastian, and... Mike in transition. Johansson, he's going to pop it.
Nice.
And Bespin with the offensive rebound. Oh, great read by Hollins.
Yeah.
That's a veteran move right there. Fanning, this is 2 points.
Oh.
Unfortunately, Brett lost his footing.
Yeah,
he came in late, lost his footing. There's no doubt about that foul. I am very impressed with that young man. Eric Fanning, that has been impressive.
Yeah.
Let's see here, a substitution. Hollins goes out, Nimmitt comes into the game once again. Showing their depth again.
Yeah.
His first substitution, it came late, but he stayed in the game for almost 8 or 9 minutes, if I remember correctly, and looked real good. Also a good shooter.
Hollins got a quick 9 points on the board now.
Just these dagger threes, you just can't let him get his sight set on the bucket. Just automatic then. Fanning makes the second one, stretches the lead back to 22. Johansson is going to bring the ball up. Gunnarsson on the wing. Person up top. Mike Palm sets the screen, goes inside. Bispin for the triple, ring out. Palm working hard on the rebounds, but
Mike's
Sebastian Cart
really
came right in there and snatched that rebound. Nemeth, Bispin hesitant on the switch. Attack from Akos. Ooh, that was close to an offensive foul, but big guy on little guy, he got away with it. But
good block.
You see it again. Horty is just comes in real aggressive. He's going to come out of the game now. But you know, if you're going to come in off the bench as the 11th guy off the bench, that's the way you come in. You play aggressive. You work hard. How many minutes did he put together?
He put together almost 3 minutes.
All right.
Yep.
That's all right. Person brings the ball up. He's going to go. Ooh, yep.
Good aggressive play. Yeah.
And I don't know if it's the 50th time we're going to say this tonight. Aggression pays off for Bruins. Plain and simple. Offensively, you just have to be aggressive. Let's see if Andreas Person can knock these down. Missed the first one. Free throw shooting has been an issue for Borås. Just not quite good enough. They're at 75%, but you still want it.
Oh dear. Went for the
stepped on the line there, and that will end the third quarter. We've got a 21-point game.
Yeah, Borås started good in the first couple of minutes in the third quarter, but then it was all about Kermend, and I don't know if we complain too much about Borås' offense, or is it actually that Kermend playing a pretty good defense?
They are
a little bit more athletic than Borås, so Borås got a tough time getting open, they got a tough time going to the basket and everything like that. So Kermend is actually a pretty good team and playing really good defense also. So
that
maybe go both ways there.
That is a great point. There is no doubt about it. Nothing is coming easy for Borås, and it's not just their offense.
No.
It is most definitely also Aegis Kermend's defense.
Yeah.
And they really have a lot of athletes everywhere.
Yeah, yeah.
And then when they're not athletic, they're smart. They have the right positioning. I've been real impressed with their play.
Yeah.
But looking to this fourth quarter, Borås has to work their butts off and get as close as they can.
Yeah.
The game is not over. It might be tough to get a win, but nevertheless, let's get this within 10.
Yeah. Because they have something to play for when they go down there.
Exactly.
A little bit more motivated, and actually 10 points is nothing in basketball.
It really isn't. And
if it's only 20, 25 points, that's pretty tough.
A lot of substitutions in Borås. Only man still on the floor, Brett Bisping, Jonte Persson, Giles Smith, Frederick Anderson and Emil Lundstedt are on the floor.
Yeah.
Let's see if they can stay aggressive. And in Kermend, we've got Horti is back on the floor.
Yeah.
Nemeth,
Giles.
Ban, Wright, and Sebastian Koch.
Yeah. No. Jarl Smith with three fouls, but start of only fourth quarter left, so.
Bisping trying to be aggressive here again, unfortunately loses the ball.
Maybe a little too early to take in, trying to do a move. You need to move the ball one time first to get everybody moving.
Nemeth loses his footing, speed the other way, finds Bisping. He's not hesitant.
Oh, nice.
Offensive rebound by Anderson. Kicks it back out to Bisping. He wanted to take it again. And they're going to set up the offense, but we're low on the shot clock. 6 seconds to go. Person to the rack, misses.
Oh, nice.
Ooh, Smith with a beautiful rebound and a putback. That was impressive.
Yeah.
Wright's going in the other way right away. They're calling out shirt here. Let's see what we're going to get. Cross screen for Nemeth. Back to Wright up top. Pick and roll. Horty sets a tough screen. Oop. And they're looking inside.
Yeah.
No touch there. According to Smith, it was a close one. But Borås ball, nevertheless, they're trying to feed Horty inside. And back on the floor, Eric Fanning.
Yeah. Coach taking no chances here, getting his best player in.
And you know, that it's really smart too. You got to remember, this is a two-legged, this is really the fourth of eight quarters. And even though you're up by 20, you got to remember you got to play another game. So, but good chances for several Kermend players to come in and get some action, and they have all played real well. Ooh, that's going to be offensive. Way to move on defense, Sebastian Koch. I thought he fell a little easy, but he definitely had position.
Yeah, good defense.
On the heels, as they say. And the captain's back. Hasn't gotten a chance to play too much tonight, but has been effective when he's been on the floor. And also, Milan Kovasi, who has just been a stabling force.
Yeah.
And most of all, in that situation, he has been setting some great picks that opens up a lot of the game. Let's look at this going the other way. And just because I said that, they've kind of been more brush picks, but, you know. Nevertheless, Burrow's coming the other way. person trying to be aggressive. Yes. Switches once again to the right hand. Same team. Ooh, Lundstedt gets the offensive rebound. And once again doesn't hesitate and knocks it down. He has been instant offense every time he has been in the game. Knocked down a three on his first substitution, and now he knocks down that mid-range after an offensive rebound. Ooh, high rebound. Same team, boys. Communicate. That's too bad. Right on the wing against his old college teammate. Ben with the pull-up. Off the ring. Oh, no. What a steal by Wright. Ah, he missed the layup. Burroughs is going to go the other way. Great anticipation, though, pop, by the guard.
Stop and pop. Good choice.
And Lundstedt again with the offensive rebound. Triple from Anderson. Goes off. They're going to get another one. Uh-oh. Both legs went each way. Oh, and Frederik Andersen is going to get his fourth foul.
Emil Lundstedt got his nice rebound in the middle of the lane and decided to pass instead of shooting.
Almost
maybe
too
he
bad.
Should have focused it just
but you know, that's the thing too. When you come in off the bench sometime, you're not always getting a lot of playing time and you're like, I just shot one. Maybe I should take it easy. I kind of like that. At the same time, don't forget the bucket. You're right under it and you were wide open.
Borod so far is 2-for-18 on three-pointers. So
it's tough to win basketball games when you shoot like that. It 11% from the three-point line. Nevertheless, it's a 17-point game. Yeah. They've made a small run here. Yeah. Uh-oh. Tried to get an ice or side on the wing. Couldn't quite get it, but it worked out anyway. Here's the ice again. Holland smartly gets back into the middle. Ooh, finds right. Shooter's touch. It just looks great. They're really picking them apart like that. It was great offense.
Looking for Molnar, maybe.
And Smith has that shot. Sometimes he needs to shoot it to bring the big man out, like right there. But he goes to the basket. Great attack by Smith. He definitely doesn't need to listen to me. He needs to do exactly that. Go right to the bucket, big man. Uh-oh, that's going to be a foul. Not much to talk about there. I don't know.
Put up his, I think, elbow, maybe.
Yeah. See?
Holland's going through the middle.
And a tie bite by Kerman. Like we said, the game has gotten a little closer.
Yeah.
It's 18, and like we said, you're playing eight quarters. You're not playing four.
No.
So what Borås needs to do is to eat at this lead.
Yeah. Trying to get it closer. Still 6 minutes to play here, so if they hit a couple of three-pointers, they actually could carve into the lead a little bit more.
Yeah. Yeah, 11% just, it's tough to win. Especially when your opponent's shooting 43% from the three-point line. And but you look at it too, Corman has created a lot of open looks as well.
Yeah.
And when Brose has created the open looks, the ball hasn't been going in. So that's just, you gotta knock it down when you create those open looks. And Cormand has really done that today.
Yeah.
See if we see Justin Tuyo anymore tonight.
Yeah.
I think he's been really great. And but then again, the coach feels like they don't need him.
It feels like he's playing around the team here and letting everybody play.
Yeah.
And just.
But right now they actually have the starting five on the court. So. They don't want to let Burroughs get any closer. And Burroughs with the substitution. You see Simon Gunnarsson come in for Frederik Andersen after he picked up that foul. But once again, the two small guards have looked really good.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Oh, dear.
open three-pointer, and he knocks it down.
And once again, the calmness is just impressive.
Yeah,
he's not doing anything slow. He's just calm.
It looks like he's been in Europe for 10 years.
Yeah. Yep. Lundstedt being aggressive. Hollins is going to pick up that foul on the offensive rebound. You know, but you see here, Lundstedt takes a quick three with somebody closing out at him. And Fanning had a wide open three from the wing on the other side. And of course, that's going to that's going to lead to 10% versus 45 from the three-point line. It just is.
Yeah.
And Oda need to get the ball in. Yep.
They're playing very good defense, actually.
They really are. You made a great point there. Gunnarsson, ooh. That was a knock down, but didn't get it. Uh-oh. Got to find the big man in transition there. What control. Milan Kovacic catches the ball, figures out where he's at, and finishes easy with the left hand.
Nice plays.
Really impressive from a big man. Catch, finish like that.
Yeah.
Great pass, too.
Good pass.
Under control. And just like that, it's gone from 17 to 23 in about a minute and a half.
We also have not got many points like that, easy points, but Kemal playing good defense, leading to a good transition basket and easy 2 points. So I think that's the difference also.
Absolutely agreed.
5 minutes left in the game. We'll see if Borås can do anything to pull closer here. But
And it really is a broken record from us today, but that's really what needs to happen. If there is any shot of doing anything, you know, you're going to make adjustments. They're going to figure some things out. But at the same time, it's got to be less than 23 going back to Hungary. No doubt about it. But they have been impressive today.
They have.
And there is no doubt which team has been the best team on the floor tonight. But we're hoping that Borås can show some colors here these last 5 minutes. And I love it. Lude Johansson is back on the floor and going against a veteran European guard.
And they got the zone up again there. So.
Yes, this time a 3-2 closeout from the corner. Oh, nice. Monar! Oh, he stepped on the line. That is too bad. Woo, but it was a nice dunk nevertheless.
Aggressive baseline drive. And
I missed it, but the ref was right there. I'm sure he stepped on the line. It was just too bad. Hollins up top. Gets a screen from the captain. Right, aggressive, kicks back to Hollins. Better aggressive defense from Borås here. Pass to right, he attacks. Ooh, what a move between the legs. Pulls.
Oh, took the ball.
Oh, 24 second. Wow. That would have been impressive if it went in, but at the same time, that was a tough shot. Good block by Andreas Persson.
And Kemal back to man to man.
Yep.
So it's a one session.
Like so they throw that zone at him one time, and then to throw them off a little bit, and then they go right back to man man. See, I like it when Mornar being aggressive.
Shooting.
Yeah, gotta be confident on that shot. Simon Gunnarsson is not always a confident shooter, but he's got to shoot that. Wide open tray right there. Johansson with the inbound. Little miscommunication here. Oh, backdoor. Oh, they missed Smith there. That would have been an explosion at the rim. Johansson uses the Mornar screen. Sees him on the cut. Tough. Ooh, they got to talk to each other. Smith was open right on the backside once again. Great aggressive defense by Carman.
Nothing.
Oh, miscommunication. Miscommunication. I think it was a great idea by right there. And here comes Justin Tuyu. And Akos Nemec. And also some substitutions in Borås Basket with Jonathan Persson and Brett Bisping coming back into the game. Gunnarsson on the wing. Bisping with the handoff, screen from Smith. Bisping being aggressive. Baby hook. Ooh, Smith almost tipped it in. Right on the transition. Crossover. Oh, Bisping came back to block his old teammate. Wow, he got up. That was sneaky. But Kermed not in a hurry. Cormend are just... Oh, that's going to be a dagger. Oh, my goodness. Hollins. And a timeout from Borås. Wow. Is that the third time he's done that tonight?
Just when I need it, he steps up and...
That is the presence of a veteran guard. Just anytime the clock's going down, the offense is broken down, they haven't gotten what they wanted, just give it to Hollins, clear out, and let him work.
Yeah.
Andre Hollins, impressive. I think he scored 2 points in the first half,
yeah.
And now and this half has just been...
come to life.
Yeah.
Yeah. 25 points there, lost 3 minutes, 28 seconds left in the game. Nothing looking good. Nothing looks really easy for Borås in on offense. They have to fight for everything. So, yeah.
I mean, Kerman has just come out and shown how to play.
Yeah.
From tip-off, they've been aggressive. They played disciplined, aggressive offense, but at the same time, been calm and collected and defensively.
Yeah.
They've been flying all over the place, collapsing on the play. They've been impressive. I think they will be a force to be reckoned with in this year's FIBA Europe Cup.
Yeah,
I really do. As we said in the intros,
they have conditions there also. Oh.
As we said in the intros, last year went to the round of 16, and that's just impressive. And there's the shot from Gunnarsson.
Nice.
Off the back rim, but good thing that he got it off.
Yeah.
Easy rebound for Kerman, and Wright sets up the offense. Looking to work with Tuyu. Finds Nemet in the corner, Ban swings it all the way back to Wright. Didn't quite wait for, once again, I thought he was going to dunk that one, but he has some patience, that Tuyu.
Yeah.
He gets an and one instead. They look really, really good right there. And just that's what we were talking about also in the first half, that I felt that Borås needed to do. You see that ball movement. It goes from one side all the way back to the other side. And when the attack comes, it's just so clear because the defense is having to rotate so far.
Yeah.
That's just good offense. Swing the ball, attack. Really good offense. Bisping inside. Working against the captain, little baby Hook.
Yeah.
Who gets the friendly roll. 2 points, two more points for Bisping, and he has been by far.
12.8 rebounds so far, so he had a decent game, except 1 for 6 on three-pointers. So.
Yeah. Pull up off the 24, and that will be Borås' ball. Captain having a hard time finding a rhythm with not a lot of playing time tonight, but he has been awesome on defense.
Yeah.
Clear why he is the captain. Telling everybody where to be in the right spots, always in the right position, and picking up Borås' best scorer for the night and making him work for everything. Even there, can't let him get position. That is great defense. There's no foul there, Brett. He's just forcing you to work for it. Person with the pull-up. Hey, knocked down. There we go. All right. Game needed that a little bit. We got 150 to go. Ooh. Good catch by Justin Tuyu. Oh, great fake by Akos, but he couldn't finish it. They looked like they were trying to foul there, but no call. And the double team for Brett.
Two in a row there.
Yes. Andreas for another triple. Ah, rings out. Great, great rebound by Tuyu. Easy does it. Ooh, aggressive defense by Borås. They get it back. Wow, I was about to say they are trying to foul there, and that's the second time they got to call that one. And they did. Ooh. With that last three, Borås has jumped up to 13% from the three-point line. Oh, man, they have had a tough going from outside tonight.
Yeah.
But they have moved the two-point percentage up to 41%, but it's just when, uh-oh. Smith gets a hold of the ball, and Borås will reset up top with Jonte Persson. Smith rolls to the basket. They're looking for him low. He's going to go to work. Aggressive. Ooh, missed it and the tip. Out Chandrias. Is he going to help the three-point percentage? And he is. Another knockdown for Andreas. They should have done this earlier. Yeah. Save that for the last minute. But they've cut it to 19 nevertheless. The captain's going to go aggressive. Oh, finds a shooter. What a pass cross court. Too bad that Band can't knock it down, but what a pass. Saw that developing the whole way. Gunnarsson aggressive. Oh, Bisping looks like he got fouled on the rebound. They're not in the team foul yet with 33 seconds to go, but now both teams are in the penalty. And Brett, it's not, no team foul. Baseline. There we go.
Maybe go 2-for-1 there.
Yep, definitely. You got to play to this buzzer sounds. They cannot give up on
there
this.
You go.
There we go. Get in there. All right. Bisping with the steal. Now they need a finish. Go ahead and shoot it. Then that one. There's Jonte Persson from deep. Rings out. And that's really been the story of the night. And another great rebound by Justin Tuu. And there's the swing. Captain from the corner. Rings out. And Jonte Persson is going to go all the way. Yeah. And he's going to get fouled. And that's going to be two shots. And these are important. This is for 17 points. I know that sounds.
it's a lot easier than 17 than 26, 27.
Exactly. So they've done a good job here at the end. That was the fifth foul for the captain. And Eric Fanning comes back into the game.
Maybe the coach is on him a little bit before shooting that three-pointer. He could have just run out the time there.
True.
And
true. You're right.
Game would have been over, but
you're
He wanted a three-pointer.
It's tough. Wide open corner three. You want to let that one fly. That is game over. Great game by Igis Kermend. And they will have a 17-point lead heading back home. Really impressive. Borås is going to have to do some adjustments and try to come out hard. Per, I want to thank you for tonight's broadcast. It was a pleasure broadcasting with you.
Thank you, James.
We want to thank everybody who followed the game from wherever you were watching the game around the world. And signing off, and hope to see you guys again soon.